Hello, Diana Jones. I am doing my culturally competent video for the assignment this week. How I feel to be a competent educator is you really need to understand the students that are coming in and out of your classroom, the families, the communities, and the neighborhoods where they live and come from. Each student comes from a different economic background, and sincerely caring for that student and the learning opportunities that they can have in your classroom is most respectful. All students bring different viewpoints and lots of opinions into the classroom about, you know, what you're teaching or what's going on outside of your classroom doors or what's going on outside of the school building. So offering a safe place for your classroom, for your students, to open up the learning environment in a non-conventional way, being respectful to all that they bring to the table, all their different religions, all their different cultures, all their different ethnicities, and where they stand socially on the economic scale. Not everybody is going to be middle class. You're going to have underserved students in your school and in your classroom. And as an educator, you need to know how to provide services and accommodations for those students and for those families, because it doesn't just start and end with the student. You need to really become a community, really become a family with your student, your parents, the community, and really kind of where they live. Some students live in apartments. Some students live in houses, some live in mobile homes, some are here, there, and everywhere. Some are with dad one night, mom one night, grandma. So we can't rely on everybody's background to be equal. We know equality happens, and it's in our underserved communities, our underserved students, our students on IEPs, 504s, our students needing accommodations in the classroom, extra support, you know. That doesn't mean they can't do the assignment or they're not understanding, because again, we're not all squares, and I hope all my students are not squares. I hope my classroom is not square. I hope that they come knowing that in this classroom, it is safe to learn, to grow, to make mistakes, to question, to have an opinion, and to bring in their knowledge from the outside. Bring in their cultures, bring in things they practice from home, and help us broaden the way that we learn and grow in education. We can't keep delivering the same type of education year after year to all these different generations of students and expect the same results. Because just like the world changes, our students are changing. Their parents' generations are changing. We just are still going through a pandemic. The way our students left the classroom before the pandemic, some are on a completely different level coming back. So there are struggles on both ends. To help fill those gaps as an educator, I need to outsource. I need to stay up on my knowledge. I need to know who's sitting in my classroom. What is their home language? What is their home situation? How does this student learn, and how can I offer them the best education and the best opportunity to be successful in what we are doing? I feel that really connecting with your coworkers, really bringing in resources, your counselors, your psychologists, your CSOC, your community outreach, really having all of that surround this child and this family to just make something a little bit easier or more normal, so that when they're at school, they can focus on growth mindset. They can focus on learning processes. They can focus on how they're going to problem solve, so that they're not focused the whole day on what's going on outside of the classroom walls, and how they're going to problem solve through the real world, and they can really open up academically. They can really challenge themselves. Implementing new ways to set up your classroom to provide a better learning space for movement, for challenges, you know, academically, personally, socially, and really just pushing yourself to try different type of learning styles. You don't all have the same learner all speaking English. You know, offer things in other languages to those students. If you have a translator or can get it translated, you know, if you want to pick up a new language, you know, Spanish is always going to be my language I go to because I want to be proficient. I want to know all dialects so that when I am working with my Hispanic population that is underserved in my building or in my classroom, I can speak with the parents in their language. I can speak with the student in their language, say it to them in their home language, something that they've been raised with, that they're more comfortable learning with, so that they can succeed in their way. So I'm going to have to challenge myself. I'm always going to challenge my students, and I'm always, always going to ask families and the community and the whole building to really just be a resource for every student that comes in the classroom, that comes in our building, because as an educator, we really need to go above and beyond for our kids.